Well, hello and welcome to Cimbrer Bushcraft and to Cimbrer Camp. I'm out here today to make an overnighter and I'm very excited for that. I haven't been out here for an overnighter since last May. So it's been a long time since I've been out here making an overnighter. Unfortunately, I had a bad experience when I came up here today. There's been some thieves, burglars in my shelter. Yeah, they're broken in and stole some things. Among my reindeer furs, skins I had kept here in my shelter. They also took my raven flag and some other stuff. So it's a very sad day for me because now I know that people are knowing that I have this shelter, and well, there's a big chance that they will be back. So, but I can't be out here all the time, and I actually had a trail cam up so that I could film if there were any people coming here, and of course they took that too. I haven't camouflaged it enough, so I don't think I can find the guys or the people that have broken into my shelter, and I just have to hope that if they do it again, they won't vandalize my shelter. They haven't done that this time, and I hope that's not that kind of people here. But yeah, I didn't thought it could be because it's very isolated, this place, and yeah, I haven't seen a lot of people out here, but eventually of course some will notice my shelter, and if it's the wrong people, they'll do that what they have done now. So I hope they like the furs and my little raven banner and my troll cross that I have here in my shelter that shall protect me from trolls and so on. Yeah, and as you saw, I split some woods because I have my Work Tuff stove with me today, so I can be very cozy in here. I don't think it's gonna be cold tonight, about 10 degrees Celsius, but I'm have looking forward to bring this out in my Cimbrer Camp and use this. So it's a great day for me regarding that. And of course I'm going to make some food out here, but the sun will be down about 4:50 and it will be dark about 5 o'clock. So I think the food that I'm going to prepare will be in the darkness, but of course I have some light with me so you can see what it is I'm eating. But if the weather is fine, I'll be outside with my in my fire pit, have some fire there, and if it's going to be cold, and when it's going to be cold, I go in here and sit by my Work Tuff stove and be warm and cozy in here. So I have some stuff I would like to show you. A knife I have gotten from Spain that I'm going to test, and some gifts from some of my wonderful subscribers. So I hope you enjoy and I hope you stay on. Skål, everyone. And this is a new knife I want to talk about. I got it from a company in Spain called Jeo-Tec. They make handmade knives, and this one is No. 9. I'll just take it out here. I think it's an awesome knife. Really cool. I like the shape of it, and but first of all I would like to tell you a little bit about the sheath. It's made of leather, and I can wear it in many different ways, horizontal or vertical, and it's a okay quality. There's a fire striker, a ferro rod, and a little striker. I test that later, and in here there's a little sharpening stone. So I have to take this off first. A little sharpening stone.
very cool. And it is a whetstone, natural whetstone. And they say never use oil, only water. So this is a night sheath for this knife. I like it. And here you have a little lanyard you can put around your leg if you want that, or put on the knife. There's a little hole here for that. So a very nice knife. A guy called Jose asked me if they would like to make a review of this, and of course they have a lot of knives and they are all named by numbers, number 1 and 2 and 3 and so on, and this is, as I said before, number 9. Well, a little bit about the knife. Yeah, I have something written here. The steel is Mova 58 steel, and it is stainless steel. The handle on this one is Cocobolo exotic wood. I don't know what that is, but it's very beautiful indeed. And you can have other handles on, Micarta and so on. So I think it's a very old school looking knife. I like the shape of the blade especially. And the overall length is 278 millimeters, 10.95 inch. The blade length is 130 millimeters, 5.1 inch. And the weight is 375 gram, 13.2 ounces. And with the sheath, 560 gram, 9.2 ounces. It's a full tang knife, and you can see here, you can change the handle if you want to do that. And the grip, I like the grip. You can see here, you can have your thumb there, and your finger here, and your thumb here, and then you have very nice control of this knife. And the handle, I like the handle, it's very nice. It has a good grip, and the thickness of the handle, I like it too. And yeah, I can use this for a long time without being tired. I'm sure of that. Now, I would like to test it a little bit. And first of all, I would like to show you how sharp it is when it comes from a factory. I must say, I don't know because I haven't tried it yet, so hang on. Yeah, let's see. Well, yeah, it's okay. Now, let's see how it's doing when betoning. Yeah, and I would like to try on these three different sizes. Let's do the little one first. That is nice. And then the next one, a little bit thicker. That did well too. And now for this one, look at this. Yeah, the handle actually broke off there. Yeah, perhaps this wood is too fragile for this. Thank you.
Yeah. You see. Now we have to try some feather sticks.
Yeah. First of all, I say I'm not an expert in feather sticks. But I think it's performing okay. And again, I'm not good at this, but I think this knife is okay.
Yeah, and as many of you know, a new ferro rod, it has a kind of coating, so you have to scrape before it actually works. And now I've done that, and with this little striker, there's a lot of sparks. Lots of sparks. And it's actually very, very efficient. So a good ferro rod and a wonderful striker. But what if I take the knife and use that? Can that be used? Let's see. Yeah. So it has a 19 degree spine here. You can use for your ferro rod, and it's actually performing very well. See over here, lots of sparks, big sparks. You actually don't need this striker if you want to use your knife for a scraper. That is cool. And then about this little accident, you can see here how it looks on the other side. It's a very nice design, but I believe most type of woods would make this split here. It isn't hard enough for betoning if you are hitting this point. So it's not the knives there's something wrong with. I think Jeo-Tec should consider making the design a little bit different in this part. Make it more like this. Doesn't have to have this sticking out here. It can be rounded like this, and then you won't have the problem with risking this is happening. But again, it's a little bit thing. It's a little thing that doesn't matter regarding this knife. And I think perhaps a Makita handle will not do this. So this could be a solution to
great knife from Jeo-Tec in Spain, stainless steel. I prefer carbon steel, but this one is actually performing okay, and the thickness of the blade is half a centimeters, 5 millimeters, and I like a thick blade here. So go in and check them out. Of course, I put a link in my video description so you can find this company and see if there's something that you would like. I can definitely recommend this knife. I like the handle. Perhaps a Makita handle would be nice too. I like Makita, and the sheath is it's a good sheath, old school for this one too. So Jeo-Tec in Spain, go in and check them out. And now for the things that I've got from some of my subscribers. This little folding knife, a little pocket knife. It's very old school, I like it. It's from a guy in Sussex in England. His name is Stan Smith, and he sent me this. Thank you very much, Stan. I'm very grateful for this little knife. It's the brand Albert Oates Sheffield knife, and there's a great history behind this.
Albert Oach was living in the 19th century in England, and he was a pen and pocket knife maker. And the handle here is what they call gicked bones. So it's it look a little bit like plastic, but it is actually bone. A cool knife, old school, I love it. So go in and check this out, Albert Oach, and you'll find a history that is very interesting. A company that was founded in the 19th centuries, and I think they were closed in about 1962. And it was passed over from father to son. So thank you very much, Dan. And then this one. Yeah, what is this? It's a Harley chip. Yeah. And a guy called Joe DiCaro, I think, yeah, from the States, sent me this. He know that I have been a Harley rider for many years. I don't have my Harley anymore. I sold it a couple of years ago, but he told me that he bought this for me, and there's nothing like this in Denmark, but as I can understand, every time you go to a Harley dealer, you can buy one of these, and then you can collect them and have a collection of Harley chips, so you can show your friends how many places you have been. It's very cool, and my intention was to have this out in my camp, but since there's been a burglary out here, a thief have been here, then I won't have it here. I won't risk losing this. So thank you very much, Joe. I really appreciate that, and all the pictures you are sending me from your trips. This is cool, and every time I'm hold it in my hand, I feel like I'm a Harley rider again. Yeah, then I'm going to talk about my new belt pouch or bag, my Viking inspired. And you maybe noticed on my latest video, The Wanderer, that I had this on me. And I haven't made a tutorial about this because I made it in a hurry. I was planning my video from the forest with the Wanderer, and I decided to make a new bag for my Viking belt kit. And this is the old one. Yeah, there's nothing wrong with this. It's a very cool little bag. And that was the bag I made a tour about, but I was not completely happy with the design. So I decided to try and make another one, and it came out this way. And I think this one is beautiful. Yeah, I like it very much. And it can contain all the stuff that I had in the other pouch here. I like the clothing mechanism. It's not a design that I have invented. I've seen this on the internet. This is brass that I put on here and here. And you can see the back side here, how this one is going all the way. And I stitch it and put some rivets on. I think this is a beautiful one. I treated it with lots of leather fats, so it's very dull, it's not glossy, and that's what I like. The reason why I didn't like make a tutorial about this is because it was the evening before I was going to make my video about the Wanderer. And then when I'm making such a project, if I'm going to film it at the same time, it takes double the amount of time. So I hadn't time for making a video about this. But the templates
for this I have on my website. You can find it there. I write it down here, what my website is, and go into the page that is saying templates, and then I have this one. It's not a really good template. It's not professional made, and just something I've drawn my hands. But you have an idea of how I made this and the design of it. It's very difficult to explain, but the proportions and all the things have to be perfect if the design is going to be as I like it. I put a lot of effort in making this because I wanted to make a Viking purse that looked authentic, and I think this one does. So go into my website and you can see the template there. I think you can download it. I'm working on making a link, putting the template on my Dropbox, and then making a link so you can download it in a good quality and print it out and use that if you want to make something like this. But again, for me, it's about the aesthetic feel, and this one is okay, but this one is great. That's how I feel, and I'm very fond of this. I'm going to have it on me when I'm out on my trips in the forest, and also here in my Cimbrer camp. Hope you like it too. Well, now I think it's time for a cup of coffee. Yeah. And I'm going to have spare ribs. With barbecue sauce. Save the last for when I'm turning it. Yeah. Looking delicious.
I have to burn down to some coals before I can put the grill on. I think it's ready now. A little bit burned. It's a little bit difficult to regulate the heat here, but it's looking delicious. So, two more minutes, then I can eat, and I'm hungry. And this is my meal for tonight. You know this: spare ribs and a little salad. I haven't made it myself. And a beer. Oh yeah, so delicious. And this has, don't know if you call that in English, but it's called bulgur. It looks like rice, but it's not. This log fire, I think it's the most beautiful way to make a fire in your camp. And it can burn all night here, so very slow burning.
Oh yeah, it's been a wonderful day out here, afternoon and evening. There's no wind, and it's actually warm here. I think there's about 10 degrees outside, so it's warm for this time of year. And my worktop stove is just making it even more cozier. Yeah. It's a little bit after 8 now. I've sit and watch some of the news from the USA, the president election, and it's a little, it's a thriller, yeah. Until now they haven't found out who's going to be the next president, and I'm sure a lot of you viewers from USA are very anxious for that, and I hope you are going to have a nice president, the one that will do the best thing. Yeah. Good night, everyone. See you tomorrow.
Good morning, everyone. Yeah. I'm here in Cimbrer Camp. It's a gray morning, and as you saw, I lit up my wood tuff stove, so I have to make my breakfast on that. That's cool too. It's been okay night. Actually, I've slept very well, and the weather has been calm, but as you can see, no sun at all. So now I'm going to make my breakfast and heading home to my wife and edit this video. So, and of course it's a real man breakfast, bacon and eggs and coffee. Yeah.
Yeah, and the coffee is finished.
Doesn't look much better than this. A nice breakfast. Well, this is all for now, folks. I hope you enjoyed this little video with my overnighter here in Cimbrer Camp. It's been a wonderful little trip. The weather was great yesterday. Today it's gray, but I'm going home and edit my video and spend the rest of the weekend together with my wife. I hope you also have a nice weekend, and I hope to see you again on the next one. Bye-bye and take care.